After crossing the Nullarbor, we headed into Western Australia. It was bucket list time. We're Gin and Ring, and we've been exploring Australia since 2017, and now we're headed to Hyden, the home of Wave Rock. After a brief stop in Perth, we headed inland, taking the Brookton Highway east and making our way to George Rockpool.
First stop.
We are in Western Australia.
Shut up!
Rock Gorge.
It's actually a man-made swimming hole that's not used anymore, but for the longest time, the locals used to come for a swim down here.
Pretty cool. It's our first adventure in WA.
Yeah,
and
the flies up already.
Yeah, the flies are atrocious.
Reckon we go and get some tucker?
Yeah, wouldn't mind a cup.
Done.
A cupper in WA.
I've never had a cup in WA.
We left George Rockpool, continuing on the road to Hyden with a special mini mission to accomplish.
This feels all the way back at Whalers Way, just tested the road. It's nerve-wracking.
After a night at George Rockpool, the one thing we noticed was we could hear a lot of frogs. We did some amphibious research and discovered this strange creature that only exists in Western Australia. Arriving at our new campsite, we made sure Rudy was as comfortable as possible, and then we set out to gather proof of this mythical creature's existence. After searching for hours, we were starting to lose faith. We were finding frogs of all kinds, but not the one we were after. And then it happened. We found it, the Holy Grail, the frog forbidden from jumping, the crawling toadlet of Western Australia. The next morning, after having successfully gathered proof of the crawling toadlet's existence, we headed to Wave Rock.
Hey, Brennan.
Yeah, mate.
This is our first real touristy spot in WA.
It's not a touristy spot. It's home. It's where I was born.
We used Breakers Picnic Area as our base of operations and decided to explore from there.
Goes through. You can climb through it.
That's nuts.
No thanks.
Alrighty. Making our way along the walking track, we stopped to check out the Hyden Dam before continuing along the track to the famous Wave Rock. At 15 metres high and 110 metres in length, this granite marvel has slowly been formed over 2.7 billion years.
It's unreal. It's unreal. It really looks like a wave, like more than other wave rocks look like waves.
How long is it?
80 metres.
110.
110.
How high is it?
2.6 million years ago.
Also known as Katakitch by the local indigenous people, Wave Rock is not the only site to be seen. The area offers many cultural and ecological wonders.
With Hippo's Yawn being one of the more popular sites, it wasn't long before Gin had disappeared into the mountain.
Sorry, the back of the hippo. And if I had, maybe not these slides on. I'd probably try and climb over. What a view. Thoughts?
Pretty cool. We've seen some cool animals.
But animals isn't what we're here for. We were here for one thing and one thing only. The ultimate challenge of Gin versus Ring. Who can make the highest wave run? Loser shouts coffee. We set this challenge at the highest point of Wave Rock, just in case anyone makes it over the top.
Just got to cover me.
All right, go. No, you only get one go. You wrecked your shoe. No, you wrecked it. I'll go.
All right. It's on. Get a close up of the meat and shit. Go on.
Oh shit.
Yeah. Yeah.
After descending victorious, it was now up to Jin to find us a coffin.
So last night we parked at the bottom of a dam that if it had have broke, we would have flooded. And I've just realised we've got this rock precariously balanced. And just below is the bus. Rock. Bus. Rock. Bus.
Back in Hyden Town, we grabbed some groceries at the friendliest IGA in WA, and then we went on a treasure hunt in the community op shop. Before taking off, we took a look at the cool scrap metal sculptures depicting the history of the area and its people. And then Ring got his winner's coffee.
Mmm, coffee.
We had a couple of honkers that kept interrupting our conversation. Oh no, the bloody swans, they're gone.
Yeah, I got rid of them.
Oh, did you? How?
Next on our adventure was a stop by Mulca's Cave. After escaping the high cliffs, I entered another realm of discomfort. Caves.
The only way for Ring to see the artwork left by the First Peoples of the area was to challenge his fear and step forward into the cave.
I had to step outside of my comfort zone in order to gain the gift of cultural enlightenment. So here it goes. Pushing my limits for culture is one thing, but exploring the abyss is where I draw the line.
So that's where we just came from, where the cave is, going on a little stroll.
Make sure you read all the signs on the tracks properly to save any confusion as to what it is you're actually looking at.
Don't put your hands in it.
What?
You're not meant to touch it.
What do you mean? How do you get the bloody lizard there?
The lizard trap. It's not a lizard trap, it's a water hole. Now, just do this.
Big monster going around in circles.
Yeah,
he's a big stomper. He must be, so they must be toad poles. He's done the runner under me shoe. Running a bit quick. Oh, Varley.
In 300 metres, turn left onto Seward Avenue.
Varley sugar. That's where Varley sugar comes from.
Mm-hmm. This is what I was expecting to feel in WA. Lots of vastness and colour. And I think this is the first night I really feel like, thought I saw an owl. I really feel like we're in WA. So we've been to some really popular tourist spots today and also found some off the beaten track places like this. And oh no, Tack is in the Salt Lake. What have you done? Oi, what are you doing, Dingo? Go on. Oh, nice sunset. Where is he? Yeah, I think we better give him a bit of a rinsey offy.
I bet you're thirsty.
Well, we've been at camp for 5 minutes. The bus is a bomb site. We got some op shop clothes, which this is next level, but you'll have to wait till you see that on. We got all of this and that jacket for 20 bucks.
After our first wicked adventure in WA, we leave you with the mystery of what adventures Western Australia will bring next Sunday. Thanks for watching. Hooroo.